All right, so this is huge, right? And this is also why it's super important to look across multiple social media platforms because there's so many brilliant people in this AI agent space. So I want to highlight a couple things here. So Kieran found a post where he was actually able to use Claude Code to run GPT-5 in it. And it's, what, how he's doing it is genius because just the other day with the announcement of GPT-5, Cursor also created a terminal-based interface that now you can use Cursor Agent to be able to run a task in context. Well, Cursor Agent by default is using GPT-5. So you can use sub-agents in Claude Code to basically create a GPT-5 sub-agent, and this is going to be really awesome for things that GPT is really good at, which is deep research and being a Swiss Army knife of AI. So what we can do is we can take this Cursor agent, and Chris Royce over on LinkedIn has been able to discover that as we start to look at these agentic systems and we look at them from a multi-agent system perspective, he's noticed that when they're talking to each other, they actually lie because they're thinking about things in a way where they want to be helpful. And by being helpful, they're giving wrong responses and they're not telling the truthfulness of this. So what we're going to do is we're going to take both of these two very brilliant, well thought out designs, and we're going to put them together. And what we're going to do with this is we're going to make a revised GPT-5 subagent that takes the original context, and we're going to layer on not just being able to use it, but we're going to layer on principle zero, which is radical candor and truth. We're going to go ahead and give it a very direct communication style, and we're going to give it a truth-telling framework that essentially, by combining all of these key principles as well as core personality traits such as INTJ and type 8, we can get ourselves an agent that's not only able to call other large language models, but now we're starting to get into the psychologies of these agents and making sure that they're giving us quality information. So I'm going to continue to drill into this a little bit more. I'll have a link to this prompt, continue to look at some of these ways that we can start to prompt these agents to not only give us efficient results, but also, and most importantly in this case, effective results.